Hello, welcome. Today I am drawing. You may have noticed I forgot to put in a new fun fact. One second. Oh, interesting. There's a fun fact. Oh, we have 52 followers now. How exciting! Sketch refs 23 02 06. Oh, I added a new folder for 2022, so now in my files I have 3 year folders, which is fun. The first year only has half a year's worth of stuff. The second year kind of does too, actually, because at least for a couple, like 3 months, I was really depressed, so I didn't draw basically anything. What day did I do the sketch? The 29th. This is what we're going to be thumbnailing today. Okay. So, my usual thing for drawings, my good landscape drawings, are they need a water feature, snow, conifer trees, those three at least, and a wolf, usually. So, I'm gonna try to keep with that for this one. At least one of my pieces violates one of those, except for conifer trees. Conifer trees are in all of the good ones. What is this? Yeah, it doesn't work for this concept. Also, drawing steps from above is crazy and I respect it. What a bold move. One second. Trying to find the things I'm looking for. You know that feel when you're just trying to find the things you're looking for? Think. I think this could have. This is part of what I use to reference or to draw the glow deer piece, I think. Though the glow deer piece does not have snow, so it's the exception to the snow rule. I think we're just gonna put this one down here too. Oh, it has to get so small. You know what? We don't need every last bit of this painting to be visible for the thumbnailing process. What I'm going to do for this is I'm going to make a bunch of different frames essentially, and with those frames, I am going to try to come up with a different composition for this thing. So yeah, I already did figure drawing for the day, so that's not a concern. I'm just doing a master study, but putting my own shit on it. My own characters and other stuff. Putting the requisite amount of conifer trees, which is at least two. What's the lowest number of conifer trees I've had in a piece, actually? One of the good ones. I think the piece with the least conifer trees might be the Mountain Spring render from 2021. It's also the one that's the lowest quality, just because it's the oldest. I really like how it looks, though. It feels very sketchy because the brush I did it with was very sketchy. And also, I did it when this was the first environment painting I ever properly did that ended up looking good. So, you know. Okay, it's time. Okay. 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 I'm watching Folding Ideas: The Last Airbender, and it's very funny. Actually, I'm gonna scroll through some more references before I start. Because I just realized I have a lot that I wasn't looking at. What's this one? Okay. Okie Need to go grab this. Where is the name of the train? Where's the horse? Here's the horse. I got a specific horse reference for this thing because the horse isn't fully in the painting. I'm just gonna watch more folding ideas. I really like his videos. Oh. Hello. Probably, yeah. Should be over here. Is it this one? Okay.
Can you power cord clean up?
Possibly. Is it?
He might need another bag for your fluff.
Yeah, that's possible.
Might give you time to upgrade to 2 bags of fluff.
Saw the image, I think, would be useful. Trying to find the reference I saw earlier. Thank you. Okay, I like this one pretty good. My sister's watching Lord of the Rings downstairs in the stream.
You can definitely hear it. I can hear it, so you need to close the door. Chrissy, go, go, go.
Oh no. Oh no.
Hmm.
quarterback. okay. Da da da. Okay, another folding ideas video for little old me. 7 years old, wow. He's talking about 300 in the episode I'm watching, and I might I say I hate how that movie looks. I just hate it. Every character looks fake, and all of the shadows are completely black. And it just looks... it looks like a comic book. Xerxes does look really pretty, though. Oh, he's so tall. That needs to be the frame. After all that I've come from, you're a woman I should run from. you know? I definitely like this one the most. Alright. I'll take it then. You made me yours with your lovely cures. Life is life. I don't know how it is we do things like this. After all that I've run from, no, after all that I've come from, you're the woman I should run from. Butterfly, baby, I have my doubts about your curves. Butterfly, cause I can't find nothing bad about you. Butterfly, you mess me up, you make my heart double beating. Butterfly, I don't know how it is you do things like this. That's not the right words. Wait, they were in the right order. Okay, we're gonna do color thumbnails now. I feel like I already know what I want to go with for this, but we'll see. I can't find nothing bad about you in butterfly. The idea is that the horse is moving, because that makes the moment a bit more dramatic. So I'm going to have to convey that a bit better. What the hell is the anatomy of this horse? I'm going to have to work that out. That horse is gonna need some help. How big is it in the... Gonna start more desaturated, but still orange. We're just gonna work outward from here. Okay, now we're gonna go with something just more traditionally me, I think, which is going to be bluer. Start here. The idea being for this one, the background is very cool. We're much cooler than the foreground. Whereas in the other two, the idea would be the foreground is just much more saturated, but generally the same color. Of course, the sky does influence that, so it's not really a hard rule there. I want to do 4 pieces like this, like full pieces this month. I'm thinking 2 landscapes and, other than this, a character motivated illustration. I'm thinking if I keep a good pace up, a master study a month, like of this style, could be doable. Okay. Okay. Just gonna do a quick study while we're here. Still no feedback on the thumbnails. Okay. I might just end the stream once I'm done with this. Gucci's aesthetic in commercials is really interesting to me. It's probably the most effective commercials I've ever seen, because it goes for just like just being weird. That's the aesthetic, being weird. By like choosing models who aren't super conventionally attractive, but also not like intentionally disruptive, really. They're just like, they look like normal people with very pretty eyes, I think, a lot of the time. Just a really interesting aesthetic. It sticks out to me more than most commercials, because commercials try to be, like, I don't know, often they try to be funny, which feels bad because their humor is usually awful. And I just don't like seeing people pretend to have emotions. It bothers me. It bothers me less in movies because the actors aren't trying to sell me a product, usually. But, you know, in commercials, that's literally what they're doing. I think that's part of why I like Gucci commercials also, is that the actors are not putting on a lot of emotion on their faces. They're literally just chilling out in a weird circumstance with an ostrich or something. I'm like, I don't know, I don't mind actors chilling out with an ostrich as much as I mind, like, actors laughing and stuff like that. It really bothers me for some reason. That's not what I wanted to click. As we are, will we're once apart, and I can still command your eyes, can make you smile or blush. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to be getting any feedback on that today, so I'm just going to end the stream. We'll say this looks pretty good. Thank you for joining me today. We'll get back on this tomorrow. See you later. Bye-bye.